Hi everyone, in today's video, we're going to talk about whether Java is passed by value, passed by reference, or something in between. I'll go out right away and say that the textbook answer to this question is that Java is always passed by value. Now, as we talk about it a little more, we'll realize that the answer is a little gray depending on what your definition of passed by value versus passed by reference is, and why some consider it to be pseudo passed by reference. While others say no, it is purely in the pass by value category. To highlight the differences, let's look at some code real quick. All right, I've got some boilerplate code up here in IntelliJ. And what I'm gonna do first is I'm gonna show what happens when you pass a primitive type into a function and how Java is copying the value over but not reflecting changes in that new function. Reminder quick is that Java has two different categories of types, primitive types and reference types. So we'll talk about primitive types first. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna create a new integer A and a new integer B, and we'll give A a value of 5, and we'll say that B is equal to A. Now let's call do something on B. We'll say that this will take an integer. Now what we want to do is let's change the value of temp. Let's make it 10. Get rid of that line. Now let's print out A and B. So if I'm telling you that Java uses pass by value semantics, what would you expect the printout to be? All right, and as we can see, our temp change here was indeed temporary. It was only in the context of the do something method. It didn't get reflected up in the main method. And the whole reason behind that is because whenever we're dealing with Java, we're dealing with pass by value, which in the case of primitive types means the value of the type, which in this case is 5 for A, and A for B, which is also equal to 5. We're going to only copy the value 5 in, and when we change that to 10, that doesn't get reflected up here. If I were to change the do something method to return temp, and then have that be the value of B, and as we can see here in this case, A and B have different values even though they were initially set to the same value. And the reason for that is because even though this assignment happens on line 4, on line 5 we have a new assignment, and the assignment on line 5 does not trickle back into the value of A. Again, this reiterates the concept that Java is entirely passed by value. Now that we've talked about primitive types, let's talk about reference types. I went ahead and made a custom object class here that contains a constructor taking a data element, which is then reflected in this data field. There's a printInfo method for printing the data, and then a setter for that data field. So let's change up the code a little bit. We're going to make custom object, this new custom object 5. We want to make a custom object. We'll go ahead and get rid of the return value for now. We'll make that void. And then we want to get rid of that line. We want to do a.printinfo and b.printinfo. Whoops. There we go. I said earlier that Java is entirely passed by value, and we demonstrated with primitives how that worked. What happens when we change this over to reference types? All right, now we're getting into some interesting territory here. If you look at it, we had a custom object, and we set the data to 5. We set B equal to A, and then now we're doing something, and we're setting the data to 10, and that is getting reflected. Okay, so what's going on? Well, this is a subtlety of how Java's pass-by-value semantics actually result in a pseudo pass-by-reference based on whatever your definition of pass-by-reference may be. If you're a C programmer, you might think of it as we're passing in a pointer to our data rather than the data itself. So what that means is since you're pointing to a particular address, when you copy that address value, when you dereference that address over here and change the value, you're still changing the value for the original caller as well. Now, Java object references aren't necessarily a C pointer, and in fact, we don't use that terminology in Java. Object references, as specified by the JVM, can be simply pointers. The Java Virtual Machine is allowed to entirely dictate that implementation under the hood. It's not necessarily direct pointers. Now, if you're coming from a C++ background, you might be thinking, okay, I have references and I have pointers. Yes, that's correct. Java doesn't have the same concept of a reference that you would see in C++, where a reference to a variable ends up being the same variable used in the next stack frame. That's a separate thing. That's what I would call true pass by reference. Java doesn't have that concept, and that's why a lot of folks say that Java is entirely pass by value, because what's actually happening is these reference types are that object reference we were talking about, and when you go in and you call a method with a reference type, it's copying the value of the object reference itself rather than the object data. So what that turns into is when you've got another object reference down here, you're actually modifying the original object when you call set data and you change that to 10. That's why it's reflected differently. You might wonder, why are the two the same, A and B? That's because this assignment operator is setting object reference A equal to object reference B. Now let's switch this up a little bit, and instead of calling set data, let's create a new instance and set temp equal to that. We'll set that equal to 10 right away, delete that line, and now recompile this. So now what do we think is gonna happen? All right, this is another demonstration of how Java is passed by value. We can see that we are changing the value now of the underlying variable, the custom object that got passed into this method. We're changing the value of it because we're giving it a new object reference, and that is not reflected up here. So that's an important distinction. If you're changing the reference, you're gonna actually change the object itself. If you are assigning a new reference, then you're not gonna change the original reference. So continuing our example, let's say that now we return temp. And now this needs to be a custom object. And we're gonna say B is equal here. Now what's gonna happen? All right, now we hit that last case just like we did with primitives, where A and B are different, and it's a very similar semantic reason, and that is when you assign A to object reference custom object with a value of 5, you set B to the same object reference as A, and then now here we're resetting the object reference that B uses, so now B and A are no longer using the same object reference, hence they print different data. So just to summarize, Java is always passed by value. Even if it semantically looks like there's some passed by reference concepts in there, it's always passed by value. This is very similar to C, where in C, everything is passed by value as well. You actually can't give a reference to a variable. You can only give a pointer pointing to an address of a variable, and that's passed by value to the function that then uses it. Now, you contrast that with something like C++, where you have regular variables, you've got pointers, and you've got references. That has a concept of both pass by value and pass by reference. Then you've got Python over here, which is pass by assignment, which semantically is actually pretty similar to Java's always pass by value of primitive types and reference types, but it's handled slightly differently under the hood, and that could be a topic for another discussion. I hope this video was helpful in clarifying that Java is always passed by value, even though it can look like pseudo passed by reference in the context of reference types. If you like this video, please do hit that like button. Please do take a moment to subscribe to the channel if you haven't already and you're enjoying the content. If you have any thoughts on this video, or if you have any ideas of other video topics that I should address, please leave a comment below. Thank you all for watching. Hope to see you next time, and have a good day. Take care.